Hey friends, we are so excited that you got to come and join with us at our block party. And this month, we're going to be talking about friendship. Jake, can you tell us what friendship means?
Oh, you bet I can. See, friendship is using your words and actions to show others you care. Can you think of a way to show a friend that you care?
Absolutely.
Yeah, so can I. Like, let me just share a few of them. Maybe you can open the door for a friend. Maybe you can save the last slice of pizza for a friend. Maybe you can socially distance, play your favorite video game online with a friend. Look, the list goes on forever. There's so many ways to be a good friend.
Yeah, and I'm sure that we have some amazing friends out there watching today. But before we get into our lesson on friendship, why don't we practice our memory verse that we learned last week? How about I say it first, and Jake, you and our friends at home say it after me.
I would love it.
Okay. A friend loves. At all times. They are there to help.
When trouble comes.
Proverbs 17:17, nerve.
Proverbs 17:17, nerve.
Now, I'm sure that you guys did a great job. And just remember to keep practicing your memory verse. The more you learn this one and get it in your head, the more God will help you to become a better friend.
Now we should invite up one of our better friends, Cody, to help us sing some songs of worship. So join us in singing and dancing.
Let's continue to sing about the never-ending and never-failing love of God. Let's sing this out together.
No shadow you won't light up, a mountain you won't climb. sing it.
There's no shadow.
We're so thankful for your love. God, a love that's never ending. God, a love that never fails us, God. God, a love that continues just to chase us down time and time again. God, I pray that we would just have open hearts and open ears to that love today. God, we love you. Praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
That was so awesome. Thank you so much, Cody, for being a good friend and for helping us in some worship. Now today, we're going to be talking about a couple friends in the Bible that were friends through some pretty crazy times. And that's pretty fitting because Andy is my friend here and we've been friends through some crazy times. Watch this. So Andy, when I was hiking and that giant grizzly bear came and I thought I was going to become a bear snack, who was there to help me out?
I was.
And when we are hanging out with our other friends and getting some lunch, and we all bring our own lunch, who brings an extra sandwich because they know I'm going to forget every time?
I do.
And when I'm having a bad day, and maybe I get a little frustrated and I'm mean to my friends, who's always the first one to forgive me?
I am. But the thing is that I'm not perfect, and I look for examples in the Bible of people that have done this right. So why don't we go and check out the So-and-So Show and see what these friends did to stay close.
Hey, man. How you doing? You got everything? Did you bring them?
You know it. Oh, how about you?
Of course, buddy.
Then let's do this thing.
All right. Hit it. Yeah! All right! Build! Oh, yeah! Go! Let's go! Woo! Ow! That's hard and it hurt!
Woo! Are you sure this is how you have a block party?
And I'm John, and this is
the So-and-So Show. On this show, John and I hang out here talking together about the world we live in. We learn a little something about God, and then we discover what it means to be human.
Man, we do all that? We're good.
I know. And today's no different. We've got a fun day planned, and we're going to get started with a little game we like to call the $1,000 Triangle. John, show me the money. You don't have the money?
I spent it all on olives.
What? Never mind. Okay, today we're going to play a little game called the $25, $26, $27, $28, and $0.31
Woo!
Triangle.
It's time for the $28.31 triangle!
All right, here's how the game works. I'm going to try and get John to guess the answer on each of these cards. Shouldn't be too tough because the category is famous duos, people or things that go together. John, are you ready to play $28.31 triangle?
You bet I am, Brandon.
Then let's play. Okay, here we go. Number one. Okay, this is something that you write with and something that you write on.
Oh, a chisel and stone tablet.
No, it's a little more modern than that.
Oh, a finger and an iPad.
No. Okay, think about this. This is very common. It's something you write with, something you write on. These are two things that go together. They are...
Mortal and pestle.
No, what? Pass, next one. All right, okay, you can get this one. This is, okay. These are two things that taste great between two slices of bread.
Oh, what is anchovies and mayonnaise?
No.
Oh, ketchup and sugar.
No, okay, it's one of the most famous sandwiches you can think of.
To all beef patties, special sauce, lettuce, cheese, pickles, onions, on a sesame seed bun.
Famous duos.
Oh.
Pass. Oh, my.
Vladimir and Estragon?
Yeah. All right, these are two of the coolest guys on the planet.
Who's Thomas Alva Edison, who invented the incandescent light bulb, and Sammy Hagar?
No, these two guys, they have a lot of fun every week and help teach people about God and the Bible.
Oh, Mel Solomon and Greg.
No, these two guys are the hosts of the So-and-So Show.
Stephen and Lawson?
No. It's the people hosting the show right now. Right now, they're also playing the game, $28.31. Triangle. They are. It's me and you, John. Me and you.
Oh.
Unbelievable.
I was so close.
You only got one right.
But who eats peanut butter with jelly?
Me. It's Bible story time with Kellen.
Oh, man.
Hello, my friends. How's it going?
Pretty good, Kellen. John didn't know we were a famous duo.
Oh, I thought we were a famous trio.
Hey, you're right.
That's why I missed it.
Yeah. What story do you have for us today?
Well, speaking of duos, today I want to talk about one of the most famous duos in history, David and Jonathan. And to help me do that, please welcome the So-and-So Show players. Ooh. Jonathan was the prince of Israel.
Hi, I'm Jonathan.
And his dad, King Saul, was the very first king of Israel.
I am king.
David was Jonathan's best friend.
Hi, I'm David.
He killed Goliath.
He was a really mean giant.
David was a national hero, and everyone loved him.
Oh, stop.
And... don't tell Saul and Jonathan this, but God had decided that David was going to be the next king of Israel.
What'd he say?
I'm just telling the story. Still, Jonathan loved David, and he gave his friend gifts that were good enough for a prince.
Here, friend. It's my bow and arrow.
Thank you, best friend.
And my princely tunic.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
For you. And my favorite pillow, my favorite soccer ball.
Thank you.
Hold on. There's more to come. And all of the important things. You'll sleep well with him.
Thank you.
This will help you in a jam.
Thank you.
And this will always provide the light just the way you want it.
Oh, thank you.
Jonathan probably didn't give David a lampshade, but you get the idea. They were best friends. Unfortunately, King Saul was jealous of David because everyone liked him so much. So King Saul sorta wanted to kill David.
Why did your dad want to kill me? What did I do?
Well, he's not gonna kill you. Dad tells me everything. He wouldn't keep something like that from me.
Maybe he didn't tell you because he knows how close we are.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. What do you want me to do?
I'm supposed to eat with the king at the new moon feast tomorrow. Tell them that I couldn't make it. And if he gets mad, then you'll know for sure he's trying to kill me. Can you do that?
Yeah, I'll do it. I'll do it.
Wait. How will I know how your father reacts?
Hmm. I have an oddly over-elaborate plan that might just work. Mm-hmm. You see that stone out there?
Yes.
I want you to wait by that stone. There. After the feast, I'll come out with a servant, and I'll shoot 3 arrows into the field. And if everything is okay, I'll say, look, the arrows are on this side of you. And if I find out that Dad wants to kill you, I'll say, look, the arrows are far, far beyond you. And if I say that, then you definitely need to run. Okay? All right? Got it? Okay.
Why wouldn't you just send your servant out there to tell me?
There's no time for discussion, okay? The game is afoot. Let's go. Go on.
Okay.
The plan was in place. Everything was set. David had chosen not to eat with the king at the new moon feast. The only question was, how would King Saul react? Well, on the second night of the feast, King Saul noticed something was missing.
Son?
Yes, father?
Where?
Yes.
Is?
Yes.
The catsup!
Oh, it's, right here. Right, it's right here. Oh,
thank you. Thank you.
And,
thank
you. I believe it's pronounced ketchup, last I heard.
Huh. Yeah, well, the more you know. Also, where?
Yes, Father.
Is...
Yes, the mustard. It's right there. Yeah.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you.
No problem.
There's a little red, a little yellow. Makes a very happy fellow. Very good. Now, oh, son.
Yes, father.
Where's David?
He wanted to go visit his family, so I let him go.
What? Now, do you not realize that as long as he is alive, you will never be king? David must die!
But he hasn't done anything!
King Saul was so angry, he grabbed a spear and threw it at his own son.
I'm going to throw this spear at you.
No, no.
You best
no.
run!
No!
You best run!
Not a pickle spear, an actual spear, but whatever. The spear missed Jonathan, and Jonathan had all the information that he needed. King Saul wanted to kill David, so it was time to send David the signal.
Come! Unnamed servant from the Bible, let's shoot some arrows into the field for no mysterious reason whatsoever.
Shall I make the sound, sire?
Oh, shall you make the sound? Don't you always make the sound?
Very good.
Thank you. Very good. Very good.
Excellent marksmanship, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Very good. Now, run out into the field and collect those arrows.
But they're just right there.
Go!
Okay.
Hurry! Run fast! Don't stop! The arrows are far beyond you!
I feel like you're not even looking at me.
Just go! Run!
Have I gotten there yet? Okay. Got him. Yahtzee. All right.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Very well, lad. You take those weapons back to town.
Okay.
When the servant left, David came out of hiding and met his friend on the field one last time.
Get up. Promise me you'll always be kind to my family, even after my father is gone.
I promise.
In the name of the Lord, you and I have made a promise to be friends. It's not only a promise between us, but between our children after us.
Yes.
Go in peace.
By protecting David that day, Jonathan saved the life of the future king of Israel. But more importantly than that, he saved his friend. The end. How about a hand for the so-and-so show players?
Wow, what an incredible story.
I know, Jonathan was a prince, so by saving David, he was basically giving up the throne.
And that's risking amazing. His life. I mean, Jonathan really laid everything on the line for his friend.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's what friends do, isn't it? They love each other. They're patient and kind. They protect each other and never give up on each other. It's like the Apostle Paul wrote in his letter to the Corinthians, love never fails.
Never? I'm not sure I'm that good of a friend. No offense.
No, I'm with you.
It's true. I think if we really want to love like a true friend, we're going to need God's help. He knows more about love than anyone. Well, think about it. He sent his son, Jesus, to die for us so that we would know how important we are to him. Talk about laying everything on the line.
Yeah, that's so true. Thanks, Kellen.
You bet. I'll catch you guys later.
See ya. Huh.
Bye, Kellen. So if God went out of his way to show us how important we are to him, and if Jonathan went out of his way to show David how important he was, what does that mean for us?
Don't ask me, ask them.
All right, reveal the question. How can you show your friends they're important? Yeah. What are some ways you can show your friends they're important to you?
Yeah, maybe give them a wrapped apple.
A wrapped apple?
Yeah, they're healthy.
Or maybe spend time with them.
Oh, you don't even have to wrap the apple if you don't want to. Just
talk about it together. How can you show your friends they are important?
You know, you've never even once given me an apple.
I'm Brandon.
And I'm John.
And this was the So-and-So Show.
Not even mashed or sauced.
Why, you would want a mashed apple?
Absolutely. Like haven't you ever had a mashed apple? What are you doing, Brandon?
Well, I'm just taking a stroll around the block.
Boo, 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 boo. Hey, you know what this is?
Eh?
It's a chip off the old block. Oh. Hey, stop being a stumbling block.
I'll knock your block off.
Blockhead.
You got any more?
No, I've got writer's block.
Now this story shows us just how good of friends that Jonathan and David were. Especially Jonathan would put his life on the line for David so many different times. But there are so many other ways that we can be good friends as well.
Yeah, you know what? I think that when I look at David and Jonathan, that's what friendship really looks like. In fact, that's what love really looks like. And God loves us so much, it's like he's one of our best friends. But I think it's important for us to think about this main question, this key question, as we go on the rest of our days. How can you show your friends that they're important? How can you show your friends that they're important?
Yeah, it's really important for us to show our friends. And there's so many different ways, like you said earlier, that we can do it. But the important thing is just to make sure that we do it and think about their needs instead of our own.
Yeah, when we think about other people and we show them we care by helping them meet their needs, that's one of the greatest gifts that we can give them. And in fact, God gave us the greatest gift ever when he sent his son Jesus down to this earth, and Jesus gave up his life to forgive us of our sins. That's a huge gift, and he did it because he loves me and Andy, and he loves you and all your friends as well. And if that's something that you want to know more about, how to start a relationship with Jesus, we are here for you. Us at the church, your parents, maybe your small group leaders, and we'd love to tell you all about it. But before we say goodbye to you today, I would love if my good friend Andy said a little prayer for us.
Absolutely. Will you guys bow your heads and pray with me? Father God, thank you so much for giving us examples in the Bible like Jonathan and David and showing us what a true friend is. I just pray that we can be true friends to our friends and show them the love that you have given us. We love you so much, and it's in your name that we pray. Amen. Now, you guys, we're so excited that you came this week. We hope that you come back next week and make sure you invite a friend to watch with you. Bye.